Hey again, Doug Sidney here. Today at Horton in Roseville, Minnesota, we're gonna show you how to perform preventative maintenance on pneumatic and friction fan clutches. Now, these types of clutches are noted for their simplicity. They've also withstood the test of time and are on a lot of the trucks you see on the road and in the shop. We're gonna use Horton's air pressure test kit and liner inspection gauge to complete the following preventative maintenance checks. Let's get after it. First, we'll check for air leaks in the system. For this test, it's important the vehicle air pressure be at normal operating level, which is 120 PSI. Listen for air leaks around the solenoid valve, filter assembly if applicable, air lines, fittings, and fan drive. Next, we'll look for air leaks. Using the spray bottle in your kit, spray soapy water on the solenoid valve, filter assembly if applicable, along the air lines, the fittings, and the fan drive. If there's an air leak, the liquid will produce bubbles. Now, if an air leak is present, clean and repair the vehicle air system as required. If the solenoid valve or fan drive are leaking, fix them with the appropriate Horton repair kit or replace the fan drive with a remanufactured or new Horton fan drive. Next, we'll check for correct air pressure to the solenoid valve and the fan drive. First though, remove the air line from the fan drive and connect it to one side of the air gauge. Using the plastic tubing supplied, install one end into the air gauge and the other end into the fan drive. If the fan drive is not easily accessible, place the gauge as close to the fan drive as possible. Remove the air supply line from the import of the solenoid valve. Install the air supply line into one side of the second air gauge. Using plastic tubing again, install one end into the solenoid valve and the other end into the air gauge. Now we'll check the air pressure at both air gauges. Minimum of 90 PSI is required to fully disengage the fan drive. If a minimum of 90 PSI is not present at the solenoid valve outport, this indicates a problem with the solenoid valve. If a minimum of 90 PSI is not present at the air supply, this indicates a problem with the air supply. The air supply should always be a minimum of 90 PSI, whether the solenoid valve is activated or not. The pressure should build from 0 to 90 PSI between the solenoid valve and the fan drive in 1 second. Air pressure should go from 90 to 0 PSI in 1 second as well. If the air pressure is present at the supply line, but not at the solenoid valve outport, check wiring connections for loose or corroded connections, or replace the solenoid valve with the appropriate Horton solenoid valve kit. If a minimum of 90 PSI isn't present at the air supply, clean and or repair vehicle air system as required. Next, check the fan drive friction surfaces. Inspect the fan drive friction facing for wear by measuring the thickness of the friction facing material. A new friction facing is 11/32 of an inch thick. Replace the friction facing material if it has worn to 1/4 of an inch thick or smaller. Now check the fan mounted friction disc surface for wear, discoloration, or other signs of overheating. If excess wear is present, check the engine control module, or ECM, programming for air conditioning run times. The fan and AC run times should be set at 60 to 90 seconds or greater to reduce friction wear and engagement. Next, check the ECM programming of the engine brake. The engine brake should be set to fan off when the engine brake is applied. Now, do a visual check for fan obstruction or shroud interference. All right, now let's check the fan drive for proper engagement and disengagement. Again, make sure the ignition switch is set to on, but do not start the engine. Manually engage and disengage the fan drive by disconnecting the electrical connector at the solenoid valve, then opening and closing the valve. Now we'll remove the air supply like we did earlier when we checked the air pressure. Try moving the fan. If it rotates with minimal force, the friction surfaces are worn beyond use. You'll need to repair them with the appropriate Horton repair kit or remanufactured or new fan drive. Now check the electrical wiring at the thermal switch, air conditioning pressure switch, and the solenoid valve. Make sure there are no loose wires or connections. Now it's time to check the bearings. Make sure the drive is disengaged. Remove the belts and check both the pulley and clutch pack bearings. Rotate the pulley in both directions and check for smooth rotation of the fan in both directions. If the bearings are rough, repair the fan drive with the appropriate new or remanufactured fan drive or repair using a Horton repair kit. Next, we'll do a visual check of the fan shroud, ring, or related components for any damage. A smooth, polished belt pulley on the fan drive or accessory drives probably means you've got some belt slippage. Also be sure to look for external damage to the fan drive components, including the pulley grooves and fan studs. Examine the condition of the belts and belt tensioner. If you have any interference, make sure it's corrected. This may mean replacing a belt and/or belt tensioner. All right, the last step is another visual check, this time of the fan itself. If you see any of the following defects, replace the fan with a new one from Horton. Check for cracked fan blades, excessive tip wear, missing rivets, cracked fan center disc, bent or deformed blades. Any of these defects can cause the fan to become unbalanced or unsafe, possibly resulting in premature bearing wear, fatigue damage, or separation at the fan or fan blades. And that's it. For more, subscribe to our YouTube channel and be sure to visit HortonWW.com.